Welcome to a land. A land that is unnatural, yet it's natural to our comprehension. A land that is quite unknown. Welcome to the ARK. A land that is filled with mystical themes, such as dinosaurs, and yet is also filled with the unknown, such as other odd, strange abnormalities in this land. This land is filled with its fair share of survival of the fittest. Only the most powerful can make it through to another day. But we are not here to talk about most of the things in this land. We are only going to review a specific few. But for now, we will go over this land and its history as best as we can. The Ark is a land made not by us, but not by nature either. It is made primarily by machine. This land is quite advanced in its own right, having made its own species and everything. This is the second coming of Earth after its fall from grace. In the distance, massive objects cover the skies with bright flurry of color. Currently, we are near the red one. But other things lurk within this land, in the oceans below. Beasts such as megalodons swim the seas, and many, many more. But we are not here to see them either. We will continue. Through this land's oceans, they are deep yet many. We see jellyfish and such swimming through the oceans, peacefully, unless disturbed. Megalodons here are somehow one of the dominant ocean predators due to their effectiveness, which is quite something to why they hadn't gone extinct. But we are not here to look at them either. We will look at something extraordinary. Something powerful. We are about to encounter a large predator of the coastal region. Currently, one of the most largest in the land. Well, at least in the coastal region, for there are much more larger beasts out there in the wild. But it does not matter. As we fly up, we can soon find our quarry. And now we shall see it. A fully grown Spinosaurus aegypticus with a much heavy size deformation, making it quite powerful and large. This is a beast of pure terror, but it is mostly peaceful. We will cover the life of this Spinosaurus. That is one of the most largest animals in the coastal region ever recorded. This is the story of a god of the seas. I will make it a note to myself not to come out exploring when it's foggy. Alright. I'm currently looking for a specimen, at least. Well, I'm not too certain I can find it. I don't think I will. Okay. Yeah, it's kind of fun. Currently, I'm moving through the jungle. A coastal region for this Spinosaurus. Quite a fascinating animal, but then again, stories from locals can always be trusted. Still, I'll keep an eye out for it. God, it's cold out here. Hey! Oh shoot! Oh shoot! Dial! Oh my god. Save my torch! Right, okay. So currently, I have survived the Therizinosaurus attack successfully, and it turned out I was next to the Spinosaurus' territory, dangerously close. So if it were not for that Therizinosaurus, I would have died. But now, it's time we see the daily life of this coastal Spinosaurus. Currently, it has woken up and is moving down to mainly find food for today and water. It knocks on trees in its path. Fishing-based predator. But it does not care. Where it needs. Currently, the only thing it needs is food. It makes it water and begins drinking. Now, a unique thing with ARK animals is that the salt water here on this land is quite edible, in fact. Currently, the Spinosaurus has drank its fill, moving on to go fishing. Nearby are some megalodons, but even if they try to attack the Spinosaurus, it will easily win in a battle with these massive sharks, which one did seem to try to do, but it was an alpha. Alpha animals, from what I know, are the most dangerous of the species. Seemingly alphas, like this Spinosaurus, go on a larger scale. So far, I have not seen any of these alpha Spinosaurus, but I have, so far, confirmingly, seen the brute as he attempts to get his fishing done. He circles around some fish before being well targeted by the megalodon. makes a loud shriek and gets back onto land, seemingly getting ready for a fight, which it accepts. It manages to beach the animal, giving it an opportunity to attack. Currently, it is attacking the Megalodon, which makes it into the water, but is unsuccessful at fleeing the Spinosaurus. As it tries to run away, the Spinosaurus pursues into the depths. This coastal Spinosaurus is named Diamond, though it does fear the deep end for bigger predators. And what has happened? The Spinosaurus is being attacked, mainly being circled, but it does not give up. More Megalodons join in on the friendly, which makes the Spinosaurus more claustrophobic and aggressive. The beast is currently swimming around in circles to lose their trail. But, like all animals, it needs to get out of there and get a higher situation to win. It takes another massive breath of air, so it doesn't suffocate and go into the water, and goes into the tail. Spinosaurus is not passionate about it. Nearly avoiding the jellyfish, which could be lethal in some cases of animals. He swims by, now having the Megalodon take a hit. Though Megalodons are quite aggressive, they aren't intelligent enough to know what's going on, though they can back out at any second. Spinosaurus reaches the shore again, rinsing the beast. He goes in for another strike. Reaching successfully fights into the bar. Thank you. As it rains, the Spinosaurus continues to hunt, getting its daily fill while piranhas are hunting. Though these fiends are quite the annoyance, they can make up a good diet. Plus, it is now time to find shelter and hunker down. It sees a good waterfall area. A delightful area it could possibly until it finds permanent and forever area. I have found the Spinosaurus currently is raining and intensely. I do not know if this could be the camera put it out. Okay, yeah. That is indeed the Spinosaurus right there. Oh!